Hello and welcome to ShreeViews. Now, since I started making YouTube videos, I've always wanted to make something about UX and UX research in particular, because that's where I apply my trade in that business. And the idea never really came to me, but I've been reading the famous book Interviewing Users by Steve Portigal, one of the stalwarts in the UX industry, and the idea suddenly came to my head. In the book, Steve talks about how interviewing is a skill and that you should learn by practice and getting feedback from other people and trade stories with other people in your business where, you know, you talk about your stories in the field and so on. But one thing that almost nobody ever talks about is tape studies. So what I mean by that is observing other interviewers through video. Now, I'd ask this question to somebody who's very highly experienced in this business, and what they told me was, you know, there's some intangible aspects of a person's personality and how they conduct interviews that you really can't learn and you can't teach that. Now, personally, I thought about that a few times and I just don't agree. You see, what I'm trying to find out by doing these tape studies is if there's any aspects of what they're doing and how they're doing it that I can infer and use as a formula. I'm not trying to copy somebody's style. I'm not trying to mimic somebody and do something like that. I'm just trying to find out if there's some learnable aspects in the way they're conducting the interview that helps me augment the other things that I'm also doing, which is practicing, gaining feedback from people, talking to other interviewers and trading stories and things like that. That's what I mean by tape study. Now, these tape studies can extend further from just looking at UX researchers conducting interviews. I'm talking about all different kinds of industries. For example, let's take therapy, for example. You know, I'm looking at, let's say, Dr. K, who does these interviews on Twitch TV under the banner of Healthy Gamer GG, where they're talking to internet personalities and gamers about things. And the innate ability to sort of establish a rapport with participants that you don't know any from before, and immediately, in just a few seconds or a few minutes, and trying to be comfortable with the dead air. So, you know, small tricks like, oh, I observed in some points of time, he'll just say, you know, let me think for a minute and just sit there and, you know, think about things. Or he'll have a jug of water next to him and he'll just slowly take the jug of water and take a sip slowly, so that while observing the user and, or sorry, the participant, and that gives you enough dead air for them to respond or them to start talking. See, that those are small things that you can learn from a tape study, in my opinion. Another great example is All Gas No Brakes, the documentary series where there's the interviewer whose name I don't quite remember, but you know, he has that innate ability to again get other people to drop their guard. And by that I mean just from his appearance. He has this ill-fitting suit and he has this sort of a naive expression on his face and just his baby face kind of a look. He's a young man, and you know, he has that, he has admitted to sort of cranking up that naivety factor where he's completely naive and he doesn't know anything. He's not the expert, you know, you tell me what's on your mind, that kind of thing. And that allows the other person to drop their guard and they're just spelling everything out in a way that other interviews or other media outlets can't get. And that really exposes, especially his specialty is going to these sort of underbelly of the United States. And it's a very very involved thing, and it's a very interesting set of videos on his channel. I search for All Gas No Brakes on YouTube and look at that as well. And lastly, of course, even in Steve Portigal's book, there are a few examples of radio hosts and podcasts. I recently saw a small clip of Larry King talking about his first experience as a radio host on a radio show. Rest in peace to him, by the way. Where he talked about the first time he ever set foot in that studio and he completely blanked out and he didn't know what to say, and there was just this dead silence on the air, and he overcame that by just being completely honest with the person, saying, with his audience, saying, you know, this is my first day, I've been wanting this job for a long time, and you know, this won't happen again, apologies, but please understand. And so he was completely honest. See, that's another thing, being honest with the person you're interviewing, saying, you know, we are interested in getting your opinions on so-and-so design or so-and-so system and whatnot. That immediately breaks down any, you know, you're not a test subject. I'm not trying to be your friend or anything like that, or, you know, I'm not testing you. These kinds of things. You can say, oh, this is not a test, but there are no wrong answers, but that really sometimes itself sounds like a test, like reverse psychology kind of thing. So just, you know, being honest with, you know, this is a feature, we just want you. So again, that's an example from, I guess, a small anecdote from Larry King. And podcast hosts, you know, a good podcast from a bad podcast conversation, where there's just constant interruptions, or, you know, instead of getting a long flowing conversation, you just get chopped up bits of things. You can learn from that as well. So that's what I mean by tape studies. So in conclusion, this is what I mean by tape studies: just observing other interviewers in other environments and trying to see what you can incorporate into your own practice. And of course, you can't, as I said, the primary thing is you can't substitute practice. You have to interview more and more people. You have to keep asking feedback from people who are more experienced than yourself. And you can, again, trade stories from other interviewers who have been in this business for different amounts of time. Just a bit more background about why I'm so passionate about this subject. I was born and brought up in Mumbai, India area, and it's a completely different cultural background than where I'm living now, which is in the United States. And I made a video about this, where people in their teenage and young adults, they tend to have this retail experience working at a fast food restaurant or some other restaurant, and where you get this practice of constantly being in front of people and establishing rapport in a small period of time. And that's something that I haven't had, because I had more of a sheltered experience, more of an academic sort of training background and things of that nature. I'll link to that video later on, but that's why I'm so passionate about it. You know, I need to catch up with other people who are much more naturally situated in this environment of the United States, and they're culturally embedded into it, and everything's like second nature. For me, it's not a second nature, so I have to augment everything by observing and learning. And again, it's my personal learning style. I'm learning through these kind of tape studies. And I'd like to know everybody's thoughts on this. What are your thoughts on tape studies? Am I off base completely, and the only way is through practice and feedback, or am I right, or is there something in between? Let me know. And thanks so much for watching. And remember, the answer is always, it depends. I'll see you next time.